Hi, this is Dr. Bhumika, and I'm your dentist for today. I'm MDS into periodontology and implantology, and I've been practicing in Nagpur, Mumbai, and now in Pune since almost a decade. Of course, we are enough much aware about the oral hygiene status of ours, but not to the extent to drag us to a dentist. We take suggestions from our friends, relatives, we change our toothbrushes, we change our toothpaste and style of brushing even. But I guess visiting to dentist is still a scary notion for everybody. So I would suggest my viewers to please make a proper protocol to visit a dentist regularly, at least once in 6 months, so that you can avail proper care and get proper suggestions from the person. And in Western countries, it's pretty different because they are pretty much aware about their status, dental status, and they really believe in health is wealth. So it's still not a slogan for them. They really believe into it. So I want my viewers also to believe into it, that we should give emphasis into proper, good oral hygiene and maintain it. As I said, people, they don't ignore, but they are a little scared about visiting the dentist. And the population which we are talking about, the geriatric population, they are a little dependent population. Dependent physically, dependent monetarily, dependent emotionally. And they think that if they are good medically, it's more than enough for them to live. It is not so. It's not okay. At least not in our generation time. So I would like them to know that it's not okay for them to just live. They have to live a quality life. Poor care, dentures, bowel early is because they are not physically that fit and they don't want to invest much into the products which we have to buy for the denture maintenance. They think that cleaning water is more than enough. Maximum if somebody is bothered, then they use soaps and all, which is absolutely contradicted. Of course, the quality of life is badly hampered. You don't look nice, you don't smell nice, you can't speak nicely, neither you can eat nicely. So what the hell are you living for? So I would definitely tell my viewers that you deserve all good things in your life till you're still living. So please go to a dentist, visit them, take proper care, because you don't need only a medical care and a lot of medical care. Medical diseases which are associated with taking of a lot of medicines, they put you in situations which causes a lot of dental issues, and some may contribute into a lot of dental issues. The common dental issues in all adults are bad smell from the mouth, sharp edges of the teeth, a lot of food accumulation in the mouth, a lot of cavities and a lot of spaces between the teeth. All these issues are majorly, I would not say all, but majorly caused by dryness of mouth, which is caused by lessening of saliva in the mouth. And this is all a vicious circle because they can't chew the food properly, the saliva is not made properly. For chewing the food, they need good set of teeth. So this is all interrelated issues. And the sharp edges of the teeth, which are caused by the wear and tear of their teeth during the all ages they have used, they put them into a situation which they can't speak properly because it hurts their lips. So cavities also lead to a lot of food accumulation, which again causes a lot of caries, and it contributes to bad smell in the mouth. So all these problems are interrelated, that I would say definitely. It's not one problem, it's a set of problems which is intermingled. And these problems, I would again emphasize, on a regular visit, you have to, firstly, is you have to take proper measurements towards cleaning. See, a clean mouth is a very essential thing, because mouth is a mirror to whole body. When you take food properly, it goes into the body and it reflects properly in the mouth only. So you have to make it absolutely clean, you have to rinse properly, and these older adults are associated with a lot of medical issues. Like they have diabetes, which give a ketonic smell in the mouth, and it's not their fault, it's a disease related thing. Like they have aphasia, they tend to forget brushing, they tend to forget cleaning, and they have also osteoporosis, which causes loss of bone. So again, loss of bone causes food accumulation, and they have a lot of diseases like arthritis, which causes difficulty in closing their mouth properly. And they have even Parkinson's disease, in which they cannot have proper movements of their hand, proper movements of their body as they desire. So all these things make them very dependable. They cannot do what they want. But we have to avail extra hands for their cleanliness and all of dentures of their mouths. So please keep your mouth clean. That is utmost important. See, at this age, the tooth is absolutely held properly in position by the gums. The bone are getting degraded. So it's gums which is going to hold. Like for proper plantation of a tree, you need good quality of soil. Similarly, for a proper tooth position and a healthy tooth position, we need good quality of bone and good quality of gums. So you have to take care of your gums and bone properly, and you have to take a proper diet, which is also very important, a fibrous diet, so that your saliva is also exudated properly and helps in cleaning of your tooth naturally. And you have to drink plenty of water. Dry mouth is one of the major issues in older adults, because our salivary glands, they have degraded with aging and all. A lot of calcinosis, that is deposition of calcium, occurs in the duct of these salivary glands. So the exudation of saliva is as such low because of the aging process. This is a physiological aging. So we have to compensate the decrease in saliva, which we can compensate by taking a lot of fibrous food that exudates saliva nicely. We have to take chewing gums, chew things which may activate these salivary glands. A lot of medical things are also available, which you can discuss with your physician and get proper help from them. Of course, the geriatric oral cancers has been probably increasing since last few years, and in fact in a decade. And it's almost in the worldwide population, total population, not about geriatric, it's almost 7 to 8 lakhs. And there's a death about almost 3 to 4 lakhs everywhere. Every year, and in geriatric population, there are almost 2 lakhs new cases every year. Maybe this is contributed, and of course, this is contributed because of their habits. Because of our geriatric population, when they were young, they were learned to habits like tobacco chewing, alcohol, and these two factors contribute majorly to 85% of the oral cancers, especially mouth cancer, lip cancer, under the tongue cancer, cheek cancer. This is major cause, and the other causes are like human papilloma virus, which is a sexually transmitted virus, and a lot of exposure to the sun, which is not that much in our country, of course, but like countries like there's the highest rate of cancer in New Guinea. So in our country, the major cause is tobacco chewing and alcoholism. That's it. And to prevent this, we have to definitely cessate these habits. And without this, we cannot proceed forward. The first and foremost criteria is cessation of the habits. Like a lot of clinics and a lot of these big houses, I'll not name them, of course, they give a percentage off in the dental treatments, and that's absolutely advertising of themselves. But they don't give a coverage. They give 5%, 10% off with all these different insurance companies. But yeah, dental is not covered, and whereas the scenario is totally different in the Western countries. In the Western countries, it is given by the company who are employing them. Secondly, the government gives a lot of cards, like last year it happened in Australia, I guess last to last year, that they've been $1,500 for each and every citizen. So they can avail, they are motivated to avail. The motivation on personal level is pretty much in other countries. This is lacking in our country, and dental treatment is as such costly, of course. So we have to accept the fact and hope to have such scenarios in Western countries, similar in our countries also. We are looking forward to it. Hope it works soon. In geriatric dentistry, it is a population which is very needful for the medical care, for the dental care. And it is not two different fields. I would definitely emphasize on doing. These are interrelated. There are a lot of medical issues which lead to polymedicine, that is taking a lot of medicines, and these medicines in turn aggravate the dental issues also. In foreign countries, the industries for geriatric patients are considered as special care dentistry, which is a multidisciplinary approach of all different specialists in the dentistry field. Whereas in our country, we consider it as a secondary treatment. Fine, if it pains, then we'll go. And until and unless it doesn't pain, we cannot drag ourselves to the dentist. So first, get your checkup by a physician properly, and then by a dentist properly.